Hello friends, today's topic was about grade compensation. Okay, so before starting this topic, let us understand some basics. Okay, alright, so first one, gradient. Okay, first basic topic was gradient. So according to definition, gradient means it is the rise or fall of ground with respect to horizontal. Rising or falling of the ground with respect to horizontal is called gradient. See, if you see this figure, you will get a better clarity, right? So see, you see here one dotted line here. Okay, this is a horizontal plane, right? So this is the horizontal plane. Okay, this is the horizontal plane. Now see, this portion is, see, you can see this is the ground. Okay, so this portion is horizontal. Okay, so this portion is rising above the horizontal plane. So this portion is rising. Okay, and this portion is falling. Okay, fall. So now if you see the profile of this ground, you have horizontal portion, you have rising portion, and you have falling portion. So this portion where you have rising or falling of the ground, that is called gradient. So rising or falling of the ground, okay, with respect to horizontal, so that portion is called gradient. So you have gradient here, right? So now gradient was shown or indicated in the form of 1 in n or in terms of percentage. Okay, gradient is indicated in terms of 1 in n or in terms of percentage. For example, okay, so if I say 1 in 20 or, okay, 0.5%, 1 in 20 or 0.5%. So this is how gradient was shown. Okay, this is the magnitude of gradient. Okay, this rise or this fall was 1 in 20 or 0.5%. Okay, now if gradient was rising, then it was shown with positive sign. Okay, rising gradient. If gradient was falling, then it was shown with the negative sign. Okay, so this is for falling gradient and this is for rising gradient. Now before starting next topic, so I want to tell you, what does this 1 in 20 mean? Okay, what does this 1 in 20 mean? See, if 1 in 20 means, if I go 20 meters or 20 mm ahead, then the rise will be 1 meter. Then if I go from this point further 20 meters, okay, then from here the rise will be 1 meter. Okay, similarly, if I go 20 meters further, okay, the rise from here will be, okay, 1 meter. So this is the meaning of 1 in 20. So if you join this point and this point, so you will get a rising gradient like this, right? So you will get a rising gradient like this. Okay, so this is the meaning of 1 in 20. Okay, I hope the concept of gradient was very much clear to you, right? Now let us go through next concept called ruling gradient. Okay, so what is this ruling gradient? Let us understand from this. Okay, so if you see the definition of ruling gradient, it is the steepest gradient that can be allowed in a section. Steepest gradient, or it is the maximum gradient that can be fixed in a section. So, and this ruling gradient was fixed based on engine power or loco power of the vehicle that was moving over that gradient. So see, I want to tell you through small example. See, if let us say you have a road like this and you have one more road like this. So see, this has lesser gradient or flatter gradient, this has steeper gradient, right? let us say this is theta 2 and this is theta 1. Okay. Now, for this theta 1, let us say this is gradient 1, gradient 2. If we have smaller vehicle to climb this gradient, it is very difficult. But for smaller vehicle, this gradient is suitable, right? So smaller vehicle like scooter, okay, cars, autos. So for this is not suitable, okay, because the engine power is very much limited. Power is limited. So based on engine power of the vehicle, you can use or you can fix the maximum gradient that can be allowed in the section, right? So based on type of vehicle plying over that section, okay, you will fix what is the maximum gradient that was allowed. So that maximum gradient allowed is called ruling gradient or steepest gradient or maximum gradient. So that is the meaning of ruling gradient, right? So I have told you what do you mean by gradient. I also told you about what is ruling gradient. Now let us look after our main topic called grade compensation. Okay, so grade compensation. So let us see the definition of grade compensation. It is flattening of the gradient to compensate the loss of traction because of curve apart from gradient. So what is the meaning of this? See, flattening means lowering, bringing down the value of gradient. Means suppose you have a gradient of 5%, you are making it to 4% or 3% based on your requirement. So that is flattening gradient. Why you have to flatten? Because of curve and gradient. Okay, there is loss of traction. So to overcome this force lost because of curve, you are making the gradient down. So to have clarity, let us go through this example. Okay, so you have three diagrams here. So diagram number one is a straight road. Okay, assume that this is a straight road. This is a curved road, curved track. Okay, curved track. And this is a rising gradient. Okay, so the road was rising like this, right? So now we have three cases, and the vehicle has a tractive force, or the force with which vehicle can move was T. So in case of straight road, so let us assume that you have a vehicle like this, okay, you have a vehicle like this, and the force with which the vehicle was moved was T, right? And whatever force you are applying was T, both are equal. See, suppose you are applying 20 kilonewton force on the vehicle, right? Same force will be applied over the vehicle. Okay, so that is case one. So how much you are applying? Same force was applied over the vehicle. In this case, see, let us draw the diagram like this. So you have a vehicle like this, and vehicle want to go in this direction, right? And force will be acting like this. So you are applying a force of T, okay, but actual force with which the vehicle was moved was T cos theta. So here, if you are applying 20 kilonewton force on the vehicle, actual force with which vehicle was moving was less than 20 kilonewton. Okay, so this is the case of curve. Now if you see the rising gradient case, see, you have, let us say, this gradient has slope theta. So see, this is the weight always act downward, so W, and this is theta. Okay, so this is W cos theta and this is W sin theta. So net force here is T minus W sin theta. So you are applying a force of T, but actual force with which vehicle was moving was T minus W sin theta. Okay, so now let me clear this here. So in case of straight road, if you are applying T force, okay, this is, let us say this is applied force and acting force, right? The vehicle was subjected to a force of T. In case of curved, you are applying a force of T, but the actual force the vehicle was subjected was T cos theta. In case of gradient, you are applying a force of T, but vehicle was subjected to a force of T minus W sin theta, right? So here there is loss. Here there is loss of traction, okay, but here no loss, right? Okay, so this concept is clear. So from this, it is clear that when a vehicle moves over the curve, there is loss of traction. When a vehicle moves over the gradient, there is loss of traction. But when a vehicle moves over the straight road, there is no loss of traction. Right? This is clear. Now, why we have to do grade compensation? Let us understand. Okay, so I will draw here. See, if you have a straight road and this was over the gradient, this road was over the gradient, straight plus gradient, here loss was only T minus W sin theta. Okay, but if we have a curved road and also curve plus gradient, you have two losses here. So what loss is there? Because of curve T cos theta and because of gradient T minus W sin theta. So these are the two losses here. So if you come across this case, curve plus gradient, what you are doing to compensate, to overcome the loss because of curve, you are lowering the gradient. You are making the gradient lesser. Okay? Understood? So this is the concept of grade compensation. Okay? So let us go through the definition one more time. So you are lowering the gradient by some amount so that loss because of curve was removed or overcome. This is also called curve compensation. Okay, this is also called what? Curve compensation.